Today, we will discuss about in exercises sixteen group elements. Okay. Next week, in sixteen group elements, dish number 16. Conversion of SO2 to SO3 is conversion of SO2 to SO3. SO3 is okay. Option exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction. Option B, endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction. Option C is photochemical reaction. Photochemical option D is reduction reaction. Reduction reaction. So given question is conversion of SO2 to SO3 is here exothermic reaction, endothermic reaction, photochemical reaction, reduction reaction. So now we go to here preparation of SO3 from SO2. So right, solution here 2SO2 plus O2 2SO2 plus O2 here means it forms 2SO3. Then delta H is equal to -189 kilojoule per mole. Okay, that is preparation of SO3 sulfur trioxide from SO2. Okay, here 2 moles of sulfur dioxide when combined with oxygen, it forms 2 moles of sulfur trioxide. Sulfur trioxide. So here delta H is equal to -189 kilojoule per mole. Here delta H is in negative position. That means negative. Delta H is equal to negative. That means this is a exothermic reaction. This is a exothermic reaction. So for exothermic reaction, delta H is equal to negative. For endothermic reaction, delta H is equal to positive. That means exothermic means heat releasing or energy releasing in exothermic reaction. Endothermic means heat absorbing or energy absorbing takes place. So for this question here, conversion of SO2 to SO3 is a exothermic reaction. So you write this equation. Right, next one. Next question. A solution of SO2 in water. Question number 17. A solution of SO2 in water in water reacts with H2S. Reacts with H2S. Precipitating sulfur. Here SO2 acts as. Here SO2 acts as. That is another question. Here option A, an oxidizing agent. Yeah, oxidizing agent. Option B, a reducing agent. Reducing agent. Here option C, an acid. D, a catalyst. Okay, these are options for this question. So once again, a solution of SO2 in water reacts with H2S, precipitating sulfur. Here SO2 acts as another. So when sulfur dioxide reacts with H2S, it forms sulfur precipitate. Sulfur form chestundi. So ikkada SO2 ela act chestundi, oxidizing agent gaana, reducing agent da, then the acid da, then the catalyst da. So ee four options man observe chesthe, now you can write here equation, 2 moles of H2S when combined with the sulfur dioxide. So that is SO2 reacts with H2S, hydrogen sulfide. So in this it forms precipitating sulfur, that means 3 moles of sulfur and 2 moles of water. This is reaction for this question. H2S reacts with SO2, it forms sulfur precipitate and sulfur ni form chestundi. So ee reaction lo SO2 ela act chestundi? SO2, it is an oxidizing agent or reducing agent or an acid or a catalyst. ee four options lo which is suitable for this SO2 in this reaction. So in this SO2 sulfur dioxide, so here this oxidation state is +4, in this state is 0. Okay, SO2, so SO2 sulfur dioxide, the sum of the oxidation numbers of each element is equal to 0. So oxygen oxidation number is -2. So here 2 oxygens are present, 2 2s are 4, that means -4. So equal to 0 kavalante +4. Deeniki inkoka method undi ani cheppanu chudandi. Ippudu deni manam find out cheyali, sulfur oxidation state ni find out cheyali. That means, so find out cheyali kavalante nenu emanukuntam x ankovali. So in this molecule 1 sulfur, 2 oxygens are present, so total equal to 0. Why? Because that is a neutral molecule, right? So ikkada deeni find out cheyali kabatti deeni x ankovali, plus 2 into -2 equal to 0. Ikkada -2 enduku rasam? Oxidation state is minus. So x -4 equal to 0, then x is equal to 4, that means +4. X is equal to what is here? +4. So here oxidation state of sulfur is +4. This is elemental state, so its oxidation number is 0. So in this condition, oxidation number decreases +4 to 0. +4 నుండి 0 కి ఆక్సిడేషన్ నంబర్ ఏమైంది? డిక్రీజ్ అయింది. సో ఆక్సిడేషన్ నంబర్ డిక్రీజ్ అయింది కాబట్టి ఇట్ అండర్గోస్ రిడక్షన్. ఓకే, సో హియర్ రిడక్షన్ మీన్స్ అంటే ఇది రిడక్షన్ అయిందంటే అనదర్ సబ్స్టాన్సెస్ ఏం చేస్తా ఉన్నట్టు ఆక్సిడైజ్ చేస్తా ఉన్నట్లు అర్థం. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్ ఇన్ దిస్ రియాక్టర్ SO2 acts as an oxidizing agent. So that is keyword is oxidizing agent undergoes reduction and reducing agent undergoes oxidation. Okay, that is key word for this reaction. So if you get any example, oxidizing agent undergoes reduction, reducing agent undergoes oxidation. So this substance is undergoes in reduction lo participate chesindante it acts as an oxidizing agent according to this. Okay, right. So right, note this here. సో మీకు ఇంకా క్లారిఫికేషన్ కావాలంటే డిఫరెన్సెస్ బిట్వీన్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ అండ్ రిడక్షన్ హియర్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ అండ్ రిడక్షన్ రైట్. ఆక్సిడేషన్ మీన్స్ లాస్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్, ఆక్సిడేషన్ మీన్స్ loss of electron. Reduction means gains of electron. Oxidation means loss of electron, reduction means gains of electron. Next one, in oxidation state increases. But in case of reduction, oxidation state decreases. And another one, addition of hydrogen is a reduction. అది ఇంకో కేసులో తీసుకోవచ్చు. So here, addition of oxygen nothing but oxidation or removal of hydrogen. ఇక్కడ సింపుల్ కన్ఫ్యూజన్ లేకుండా చూడండి, addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen, that is oxidation. Reduction means addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen, that is reduction. So for this reaction, these both are suitable here. Oxidation means loss of electron or oxidation state is increases. But in case of reduction, gains of electrons takes place here. In reduction, oxidation state decreases. But here, SO2 plus 4 to 0 ante oxidation state decrease ayindi kada. So oxidation state decrease ayithe unnadi ikkada reduction. So it is reduction. So reduction lo involve avuta undante, that is oxidizing agent. There is no any confusion. It is very simple thing. Okay, oxidizing agent undergoes reduction. Sulfur dioxide reduction lo participate chesindi kabatti ee SO2 ni oxidizing agent ani cheptam. Oxidizing agent, okay, ante idi reduction lo participate chesindi ante another substance ni oxidize chesindi ani artham. Okay, so it is oxidizing agent, right. Idi note chesukondi. Okay, next one. Question number 8, only solutions matrame note chesukovali. క్వశ్చన్స్ అన్ని బుక్ లో ఉంటాయి. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 18, విచ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫాలోయింగ్ ఈజ్ ఎ రెడ్ లిక్విడ్? Which of the following is a red liquid? Okay. Option A, SF4, B, SF6, C, SCl2, D, S2Cl2. Right? Okay. So among these substances, which one is red liquid? So manam dihalides cheptunnama, SCl2, it is a foil smelling red liquid ani cheppanu chudandi. Foil smelling red liquid. So this is correct answer, SCl2. It is a foil smelling red liquid. So another one is hybridization of oxygen in O2F2. This is question. Hybridization of oxygen in O2F2. So hydrogenation manam shortcut method cheppina idea undi kada. So options sp2, sp3 and sp3d. These are options. So once again, hybridization of oxygen in O2F2. O2F2 lo oxygen hybridization enta? Sp, sp2, sp3, sp3d. So here O2F2. So in O2F2, oxygen group number is 6. Oxygen group number is 6. So two oxygens are present, 6 2 12, and fluorine group number 7, 7 2 14, 12 plus 14 26. So that is more than 8. Below 8 gaani, correct ga 8 gaani unte 2 tho buy cheyali, more than 8 unnapudu 8 tho buy cheyali. So here 26, 8 to S, 8 3 is 24, so 2 here and 2 1 is 2. So 3 plus 1, answer is 4. 3 plus 1, 4. So 4 is 7, you can get it. 2, if 2 is SP, 3, SP2, 4, SP3, 5, SP3D, 6, SP3D2. So given answer is, coming answer is 4. So that means SP3 hybridization, option C is correct answer. Option C. So that is, that means hybridization of oxygen in O2F2, SP3 hybridization. So, you note this problem. Which of the following is a red liquid or not? SCLT is a foil smelling red liquid. And another question is, hybridization of oxygen in O2F2 is SP3. That means in O2F2, oxygen undergoes SP3 hybridization. So the structure is similar to the hydrogen peroxide. The O2F2 structure is it is similar to hydrogen peroxide. So next one, क्वेश्चन नंबर 24 इक थीरी कवर अयिन बिट्स मात्रमे एक्सप्लेन चेस्ता उन्नानु इंका 102 क्लासेस लो ई 16th ग्रूप मोत्तम कंप्लीट अयिपोतुंदी वाटि रिमेनिंग तर्वात कूडा एक्सप्लेन चेस्तुन्नामु नेक्स्ट वन क्वेश्चन नंबर 24 इट इज ऑन ओजोन कांसेप्ट ओजोन पैन डिपेंडेंट उंदी इदी ओके सो बिट नंबर 24 हियर which of the following metal loses its meniscus after reacting with ozone its meniscus after reacting with ozone okay so here option a pb lead b mercury c copper d silver right here Which of the following metal loses its meniscus after reacting with ozone? So that is mercury. Mercury. When ozone is passing through the mercury, this oxidizes into mercurous oxide. Then it loses its meniscus and it sticks the glass wall. That is tailing of mercury. It is important thing and cheptam chudandi so here mercury reacts with ozone that means ozone when passing through the mercury it oxidizes to mercurous oxide and O2 so ozone ni mercury guna pass chesthe ee mercury anedi mercurous oxide ga oxidize avutundamma mercurous oxide then this mercury loses its meniscus and sticks the glass wall then it is called tailing of mercury okay right when regain the meniscus nature after shaking with water so water tho malla din shake chesinappudu aa meniscus nature ni malla regain chestund anamata so that is option is mercury this is reaction so we note chesukonna akada okay next one next bit is 25 silver on warming in O3 in O3 the reaction is right so option A oxidation of the metal option B formation of ozonide and option C alternate oxidation of the metal and reduction of the oxide takes place. And fourth option is reduction of metal. Right. Prachandi, silver and warming in ozone, the reaction is another. So silver ni ozone to react chesinappudu and heat chesinappudu akkada a reaction lo oxidation of the metal takes place or formation of ozonite takes place, alternate oxidation of the metal and reduction of the oxide takes place here and reduction of metal. So which one is correct for this reaction? So you take reaction, first of all EAZ, that means silver. Two moles of silver when react with ozone, it forms silver oxide and ozone. So in this reaction, oxidation state of silver is zero, in this case plus one. So 0 to plus 1, that means oxidation number increases. 0 to plus 1, oxidation number increases. So oxidation number increase endante that undergoes oxidation. Manu ikkada inna rastunnam kada oxidation, that means oxidation of metal takes place here, oxidation of metal. And alternatively silver oxide Ag2O reacts with ozone, it forms 2 moles of silver and 2 moles of dioxide. So in this condition, silver oxidation state is plus one. In this condition, silver oxidation state is zero. Why? Because it is a elemental state, that means uncombined state. So in this case, plus one to zero. So oxidation number decreases. So this is reduction. So in this condition, oxidation of the metal takes place, reduction of metal oxide takes place, like this option C. Okay, silver on warming in O3, the reaction is oxidation of the metal, reduction of the metal oxide takes place here. So this is oxidation, this is reduction. So oxidation means increasing oxidation number from 0 to plus 1, that is oxidation. But in this case, oxidation number decreases from plus 1 to 0, that means reduction. So we both note this point. Both are equation. So observation is carefully observation here. In this reaction, oxidation state of silver increases from 0 to plus 1, so that is oxidation. In this equation, plus 1 to 0, that means decreases, oxidation number decreasing, so that is reduction. Right. So next one, right, Next one is question number 26. Which is wrong about O3? Which is wrong about O3? Right. So here, four options are given. First option is, it is paramagnetic in nature. It is paramagnetic in nature. And it has a linear structure. It has a linear structure. Linear structure. And see, it decolorizes acidic KMnO4. It decolorizes. Decolorizes acidic KMnO4. And fourth option is all the above. So that is the question here. Which is wrong about O3? Ozone paranga ee four statements lo ee wrong statement annadu, anni wrong statements, all the above. Endukante chudandi, first option enti ikkada, it is paramagnetic in nature annadu, that is wrong. O3 is a diamagnetic nature. O3 is a diamagnetic. Why? Because in ozone, there is all paired electrons, not unpaired electrons. Paramagnetic analante, that must be contains at least one unpaired electron. Kanisa oka unpaired electron ana undali. Alanti condition lo maatrame daaki paramagnetic antam. But in case of ozone, there is no unpaired electron. Only paired electrons are present. So that is, ozone is a diamagnetic. So this is wrong statement about ozone. Second one, it has a linear structure anadam. That is not linear. Ozone has an angular molecule, angular shape. Ozone angular shape may exhibit out. So it decolorizes anadam. It does not decolorize as the KMnO4. So the mottam statements were wrong. So all the above. These statements were wrong, but even the tapuga manu contradict it. So, like this. All we know is correct answer for this question. Okay, next one. Question number 27. Which is correct about O3? 27. Which is correct about O3? Okay, which one is correct here? Option A, molecule is angular, and option B, bond angle is 116.5 degree. It is isoatomic with SO2. It is isoatomic with SO2. And option D, all the above. Right. So once again, I repeat the question here. Which is correct about O3? Ozone paranga, ikkada ichina ee options lo, which one is correct annadu? All are correct. That means all the above correct answer. Why? Because option A is molecule is angular molecule. So O3 has angular shape. Okay? And bond angle is 116.5 degree. This is also correct thing. It is isoatomic with SO2 annadu. So isoatomic. Isoatomic means same number of atoms present in the molecule. So here, SO2 in SO2 three atoms are present, three atoms, one is sulfur, two oxygen, 1+2=3, one sulfur atom, two oxygen atoms are present, so three atoms present in the SO2. But in case of O3, it also contains here three atoms. Okay, in both SO2 and O3 same number of atoms are present. SO2 లో 3 ఆటమ్స్ ఉన్నాయి, O3 లో 3 ఆటమ్స్ ఉన్నాయి. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఐసోఆటమిక్ విత్ SO2. ఓజోన్ ఈజ్ ఏ ఐసోఆటమిక్ విత్ SO2. అంటే ఇక్కడ SO2 లో ఎన్ని ఆటమ్స్ అయితే ఉంటాయో O3 లో కూడా అన్నీ ఉంటే దట్ ఈస్ ఐసోఆటమిక్. మరి ఉన్నాయా లేదా? SO2 లో 3 ఆటమ్స్ ఉన్నాయి, O3 లో కూడా 3 ఆటమ్స్ ఏ ఉన్నాయి. సో హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఐసోఆటమిక్ విత్ SO2. ఆల్ ఆర్ కరెక్ట్ ఆప్షన్ రైట్. ఓకే, చూడండి, ఐసోఆటమిక్ మీన్ సేమ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆటమ్స్ ఇన్ ఏ మాలిక్యూల్, సేమ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆటమ్స్. సో నెక్స్ట్ వన్ లెవెల్ 1 ఆర్ కంప్లీటెడ్. చూడండి, ఆక్సో యాసిడ్స్ అనేది పెండింగ్ ఉంది చాప్టర్, మనం క్లాస్ చెప్పాలి, టుమారో ఆన్వర్డ్ చెప్తాము. రిమైనింగ్ చూడండి, ఇక్కడ రిమైనింగ్ లో లెవెల్ 2 లో రిమైనింగ్ బిట్స్ ఇక్కడ రైట్. క్వశ్చన్ నంబర్ 1, సల్ఫర్ మెల్ట్స్ టు ఏ మొబైల్ లిక్విడ్, ఇది కొంచెం బిగ్ పెద్దదిగా ఉంది. క్వశ్చన్ నంబర్ 1 ఇన్ లెవెల్ 2, సల్ఫర్ మెల్ట్స్, సల్ఫర్ మెల్ట్ టు ఏ మొబైల్ లిక్విడ్ మొబైల్ లిక్విడ్ ఎట్ 119 degrees centigrade, but becomes viscous viscous above 160 degrees centigrade. It is due to. So option A is molten sulfur exist as a S8 at 119 degree centigrade, and option B, Packard rings are cleaved above, Packard rings are cleaved above 160 degree, and option C, open chains tangle together forming viscous sulfur, and option D is all are correct. So meer material iskunte ee problem undadu, direct oka explain chestunte ellipovachu. So here right here, so sulfur melts to a mobile liquid at 119 degrees centigrade but becomes viscous above 160 degrees centigrade, it is due to anaerobic. See, this solid sulfur is melted at this temperature. So, above 160 degrees centigrade, heat chase, it is more viscous to convert out of the anaerobic. In general, solid sulfur, you take solid sulfur, it contains S8 ring. After melt, that means after melting, it forms a liquid in yellow color. So, and solid sulfur and S8 ring from the island. As you melt in the yellow color liquid will convert out. If brain is on a condition, now temperature is increases. Temperature increases. Temperature increases, it becomes more viscous. Why? Because as the temperature increases, the SA rings are open up and join the long chain. SA rings are open up, long chains are joined. Viscosity is increased. That's why option C is correct one. Once again, but solid sulfur contains S8 ring. This S8 ring after melting, it is converting to yellow color liquid. Yellow color liquid is convert out. If temperature man increases, it will come out. This S8 ring is open up. The longest chain is linked form. Okay? Then viscosity increases. That's why. So option C is correct one here. Right. Okay, next one. Next question. Second question, the oxidation number of sulfur. Question number two, the oxidation number of sulfur in Na2S4O6 is. So given options are, option A, minus 2.5, option B, plus 2.5, option C, minus 10, D, plus 10. These are more options for this reason, for this question. So Na2S4O6. You take Na2S4O6. So in this molecule, two sodium atoms and four sulfur atoms and six oxygen atoms are present. So totally it is equal to zero. Why? Because it is a neutral molecule. So the neutral molecule, that means there is no any charge. Charge less gravity, it will be considered as a neutral molecule. So equal to zero. So right. So find out there in the end sulfur. Sulfur is like this compound. So sodium oxidation number is plus one. Why? Because sodium, it is belongs to first A group. And sulfur oxidation number find out here, Xn quali. Oxygen ki minus two equal to zero. Okay. Then 2 plus 4X minus 12 equal to 0. That means 4x is equal to 10. So 2 minus 2 outundi, minus 12 plus 10 plus 12 outundi kaabatti 10. Then x is equal to what is here? 10 by 4. That means 2 5s are 2 2s are. Means 5 by 2. 5 by 2 means 2.5. That is oxidation number of sulfur in NA to S4 OC. Once again, in NA to S4 OC, 2 sodium atoms, 4 sulfur atoms, 6 oxygen atoms are present. Like this, 2 sodium, 4 sulfur, 6 oxygen. That must be equal to 0. Why? Because it is a neutral molecule. It is a neutral molecule. So sodium oxidation state is plus 1, then 2 into 1 here, plus 4 into sulfur oxidation state is X. Why? Because it is find out. Then the DNA find out here. Plus 6 into minus 2. 6 into minus 2. That means minus 2 is a oxidation state of oxygen. So 2 into 1, 2, plus 4 into X, 4X minus 6 into minus 2, minus 12 equal to 0. So 4X is equal to 10. Then X is equal to 10 minus 10 by 4. 2 2 is 2 5 is, that means 5 by 2. So totally oxidation state is 2.5. Okay? Note this. Okay, next question. This is a theoretical question here. So, sorry, option B is correct answer here. Plus 2.5. Option B. 2.5. Right. Next question. When molten sulfur is quenched, that means cooling, the following is formed. Option A, monoclinic sulfur. B, rhombic sulfur. C, Cristex means plastic sulfur. D, gamma sulfur. So, if molten sulfur is quenching, plastic sulfur form out. So option C is correct answer. Option C. Right, next to fourth one. Second question ki B, 2 plus 2.5. This is calculation of oxidation number. Find out the oxidation number. Okay. Next one. Question number 4. O2 minus 2 is the symbol of. O2 minus 2 is the symbol of dash ion. So option A, it is oxide. Oxide. B, superoxide, superoxide. C, peroxide, monoxide, monoxide, oxide, superoxide, peroxide, monoxide. So O2 minus 2 means O minus. This is peroxide cooling case. So that is option C is correct one. That means this is peroxide. O2 minus 2 is the symbol of peroxide ion. Like this is peroxide cooling case. Next one. Next question is, question number 5, bond angle in SO2. Bond angle in SO2 is nearly. So option A, 119.5 degree. Option B, 90 degree. Option C, 180 degree. Option D, 109 degree 28 minutes. So So the, these are options. So here, bond angle in sulfur dioxide is nearly unknown. Bond angle in SO2. So you go to here, SO2 structure like this. This is structure of SO2. Bond angle is 119.5 degree. So option one is correct one. Okay. Next one. Question number 6. Which of the following contains P pi D pi bond? Question number 6 is, which of the following? Which of the following? Following contains P pi D pi bond. P pi D pi bond. Okay. Here option A, NO2. Option B, SO3. C, SO2. Option D, both two, both B and C. Both B and C. So which of the following contains P pi D pi bonds or not? P pi D pi. Okay. This is not P pi P pi. P pi P pi kaadu idi. P pi D pi bond. So here, this is answer both B and C. SO3 structure is like this. This is SO3. This is SO2. Okay, so oxygen lo unde p orbital, sulfur lo unde d orbital, vaati mante bond form avutundi ikkada. So both SO2 SO3 contain p pi d pi bond, right? Okay, next one. Next one is, which of the following oxides reacts with both HCl and NaOH? Which of the following oxides reacts with both HCl and NaOH, HCl and NaOH? Option A, CaO means calcium oxide, B, zinc oxide, C, nitrogen pentoxide, N2O5, D, CO2, carbon dioxide. So question is, which of the following oxides reacts with both HCl and NaOH? Kachandi, this is acid, this is base. Acid base renin to react kavalante, that is must be here amphoteric oxide. Amphoteric oxide mana oxide position kada, that means acidic oxide, basic oxide, amphoteric oxide and neutral oxide. So here amphoteric oxides ante the oxides which react with both acid and bases. That is amphotic. So for example, here zinc oxide. Answer for this question is zinc oxide. Why? Because this is a amphoteric oxide. Zinc oxide is a amphoteric oxide. So this reacts with both HCl and NaOH. That means zinc oxide reacts with the acid. That means HCl, nothing but acid. It forms zinc chloride and water, salt and water. So this is acid. Next one, zinc oxide reacts with the sodium hydroxide, which is base. This is base. So it forms Na2ZnO2 plus H2O. This is sodium zincate. Sodium zincate. Here is salt and water. So this zinc oxide reacts with both acid and base. So that's why it is belongs to amphoteric oxide. This is example for amphoteric oxide. So question is, which of the following oxide reacts with both HCl and NaOH? It is acid, it is base. When it reacts, kavalante amphoteric oxide undali. So zinc oxide anedi amphoteric oxide kavati. It reacts with both HCl and NaOH. Okay, right. So equation for sari velukondi zinc oxide undi kada, zinc oxide is a amphoteric oxide ani raaskondi. Okay, remaining bits to